Greetings and welcome to this video worship experience for the day of Pentecost, when we gather together as the church to proclaim the good news, Christ is risen, Christ is risen indeed, Alleluia. We also continue to shelter in place as we deal with the COVID-19 pandemic. So we urge you to continue to keep your distance and shelter in place so that we, along with our neighbors, can together stay well and save lives. This is our Christian service. 50 days after Easter, we celebrate the Holy Spirit as God's presence within and among us. So today we recall the story of the first Pentecost day, when the Holy Spirit arrived in rushing wind and flame, bringing God's presence to all people. Some say this event is the birth of the church. We celebrate that we too are given the breath of the Holy Spirit and sent out to proclaim God's redeeming love to all the world. What does the Holy Spirit mean to you? In what ways have you experienced the work and the power of the Holy Spirit? During this video worship experience, we're not able to receive an offering. Financial offerings can be sent through the mail, electronically, or online on the Peace Lutheran Church website. If you would like to be a sponsor of these video worship experiences, contact the church office. We now move to Thanksgiving for baptism, where we remember that through baptism, we receive the Holy Spirit and experience God's love and grace. Our baptism commissions us to share Jesus' mission in the world. And through baptism, we die to sin and rise with Christ. Alleluia. Christ is risen. Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia. Joined to Christ in the waters of baptism, we are raised with him to new life. Let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We give you thanks, O God, for in the beginning you created us in your image and planted us in a well-watered garden. In the desert, you promised pools of water for the parched, and you gave us water from the rock. When we did not know the way, you sent the good shepherd to lead us to still waters. At the cross, you watered us from Jesus' wounded side, and on this day, you shower us again with the water of life. We praise you for your salvation through water, for the water in this font, and for all water everywhere. Bathe us in your forgiveness, grace, and love. Satisfy the thirsty and give us the life only you can give. To you be given honor and praise through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Spirit, Spirit of restlessness, stir me from
Let us pray. O God, on this day, you open the hearts of your faithful people by sending into us your Holy Spirit. Direct us by the light of that Spirit, that we may have a right judgment in all things and rejoice at all times in your peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
A reading from Acts 2. When the day of Pentecost had come, the apostles were all together in one place. And suddenly, from heaven, there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my Spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heavens above, and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness, and the moon to blood, before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious days. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Preach the
The Holy Gospel for the day of Pentecost, according to John, the 20th chapter. When it was evening on that day of resurrection, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." After Jesus said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When Jesus had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained." This is the gospel of the Lord. Grace and peace to you from God, who comes and meets us as a loving creator, as the risen and living Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and as the active, moving Holy Spirit, who opens us to faith and gathers us to be the church. Amen. For my first call, I was sent to what was then known as Faith Evergreen Lutheran Church, located in East San Jose. I was sent to redevelop this congregation. In other words, as the redevelopment pastor, my responsibilities and tasks included: complete the merger of Faith and Evergreen Lutheran congregations, sell Faith Lutheran Church's property, move the congregation into a temporary worship location, maintain the existing membership of these two congregations, begin a building program, knock on doors, grow the congregation, and reorganize two congregations into one congregation. Now keep in mind, this was my first call. In hindsight, I probably chewed off more than I could have handled. Since this was my first call, I'll admit that I was inexperienced. Many of these tasks were new to me. I flew by the seat of my pants and I made my share of mistakes. Fortunately, I was blessed with a cadre of committed parishioners who were willing to work with me, who were patient with me, and who forgave me my mistakes. And amazingly, in spite of me, we were able to redevelop this congregation. We became known as Grace Lutheran Church, located in the Evergreen Valley area of East San Jose. And this congregation continues to live and minister. I'm amazed every time I remember Grace Lutheran Church. I'm amazed because most redevelopments don't work and don't make it. I know that Grace Lutheran Church is the result of more than simply my effort, and more than the effort of the parishioners who hung in there with me. When I remember Grace Lutheran Church, I'm amazed that this congregation survived my tenure as their redevelopment pastor. And I give credit to the Holy Spirit for Grace Lutheran Church's existence today. When I recall my adventures at Grace Lutheran Church, I can see the Holy Spirit's fingerprints all over the place, and I continue to be amazed. Today is the day of Pentecost. On this day, we recall that all of us have received the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit gathers us to be the church, to be the body of Christ in the world. And I'm amazed at the Holy Spirit's work among us and in the world. Recall today's reading from Acts. All who were present during the festival of Pentecost in Jerusalem were amazed and astonished at what was happening around and among them. They were from all over the world. The Galileans who followed Jesus were amazed that they were able to speak in a wide variety of languages to proclaim and to share the story of what God had done for them, for humanity, and for all creation. At the same time, the listeners were amazed when they heard the story about God spoken in their own languages and understood what was being said to them by these Galileans. This gathering of Jews, the proclamation of God's story, and the variety of languages occurred in the midst of windy conditions, a firestorm of activity, a very noisy room, and a great deal of commotion and confusion. On that first Pentecost day, God worked through the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit pushed people together, forced interaction among diverse people, generated an encounter with powerful words and inspired communication. Simultaneously, all these people who were gathered there were perplexed, surprised, caught off guard, bewildered, and wondered, what does this mean? What does this amazing Pentecost day mean for us? When we recall the day of Pentecost, we immediately realize that it is a story about the Holy Spirit and the work of the Holy Spirit. The early Christians were amazed that within a generation after the resurrection of Jesus Christ, Christianity had spread throughout the Mediterranean world and beyond. They wondered, how was this possible? They looked at themselves and saw that they were mostly poor, common, ordinary folks. And their fair share, and they had their fair share of limitations, problems, shortcomings, and of course, sin. They lived on the margins of the Roman Empire. They faced persecution and enslavement. They lacked the political power, the military might, and the influence to force people to follow Jesus. They certainly weren't like the Roman army. When they examined themselves, they wondered, how was it possible for the way of Jesus Christ to have spread so far and so quickly into the known world? They realized that they couldn't have done it on their own. They realized that a power greater than them was at work in making Jesus Christ known to the people around them. These early Christians concluded that the Holy Spirit was responsible for spreading the way of Jesus and for opening people's hearts and minds to come to faith and to see Jesus is the Christ, who is the Savior and the chosen one of God. For us today, one meaning of the day of Pentecost is to show that the Holy Spirit provides us with the power to proclaim the good news of God's deeds and to move people to develop a relationship with Jesus Christ. Another meaning of Pentecost is that the Holy Spirit works through people and empowers people to proclaim the good news of God's deeds and to be witnesses for Jesus Christ. Did you notice that on the day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit worked through people? The Holy Spirit gave them the ability to speak other languages and the ability to connect with people so that the listeners would be able to hear and understand the proclamation of the story and of God and of God's mighty deeds. The Holy Spirit didn't operate in a vacuum. The Holy Spirit didn't simply speak. Instead, the Holy Spirit provided the power, the motivation, the inspiration, the faith, and the abilities for the followers of Jesus to be witnesses and to share the way of Jesus. As we remember how the Holy Spirit worked through the people of that first Pentecost day, now is a good time for us to recall how each of us came to know Jesus, to become a part of the church, and to grow in our individual relationships with Jesus. When we look back on our particular faith journeys, we quickly realize that people, fellow Christians, passed on the story of Jesus to us and provided the wisdom, support, inspiration, and guidance to help us grow in faith and in our relationship with Jesus Christ. Where would each of us be without the people who have journeyed with us on our faith journeys? The Holy Spirit uses people to pass on the stories of faith and the faith to people. We stand on the shoulders of the saints who have gone before us. We are members of the communion of saints. And the Holy Spirit worked through these saints to bring us to Jesus and to grow our relationship with Jesus Christ. And now on this Pentecost day, this same Holy Spirit continues to move among us and beckons us to come to follow in the footsteps of the saints who have gone before us and to do likewise to make Christ known to other people. This same Holy Spirit calls us, empowers us, inspires us, and gives us the abilities and gifts to be witnesses and ministers for Jesus in today's world. Which brings us to the next meaning of the day of Pentecost for us today. When we recall the day of Pentecost, we see that the Holy Spirit worked through the proclamation of the followers of Jesus and moved hearers to come to Jesus. By the end of that day, 3,000 persons were baptized and added to the church. In other words, the day of Pentecost tells us that the Holy Spirit is in the business of gathering people and in building up the church. The Holy Spirit works through us, inspires us, and equips us to be witnesses so that we can share Jesus with the people around us, and through us, people will come to know Jesus. Then the Holy Spirit continues to blow us into the world toward all nations and peoples so that we can share the good news of the risen and living Jesus Christ. In a multicultural, multilingual, pluralistic world filled with a diversity of people, the Holy Spirit working through us is able to bring people together, and all these people together become the church. God has always intended for the church to be multicultural and filled with diverse peoples of all backgrounds. When I entered seminary, I remember learning about the ethnic history of the Lutheran Church. Northern Europeans from Northern Europe and Scandinavia immigrated to the United States and brought the Lutheran Church with them. Danes, Germans, Finns, Icelanders, Norwegians, Swedes, and the reality is when we look at the history of these Europeans from these Lutherans from Northern Europe, God forbid that they should actually come together to be a church together. As a matter of fact, in 1875, there were over 70 different Lutheran church bodies in these United States, and all divided by language, culture, geographical location, and Lutheran doctrine. I never thought in my lifetime that I would ever see a Lutheran church body that would bring together Danes, Germans, Finns, Icelanders, Norwegians, Swedes, and even other Northern Europeans. And the ELCA, the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, also includes Eastern Europeans from Estonia, Hungary, Latvia, and Lithuania. In other words, in my lifetime, the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America brings together all these various Europeans to become one Lutheran church. Who would have thought? In addition, on any given Sunday in the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, 35 different languages are used in worship. Arabic, Amharic, Cambodian, Chinese dialects of Cantonese and Mandarin, Creole, Danish, English, Estonian, Finnish, German, Hmong, Hungarian, Indonesian, Inupiat, Japanese, Korean, Latvian, Lao, Norwegian, Nuer, which is a Sudanese dialect, Navajo, Oromo, which is an Ethiopian dialect, Portuguese, American Sign, Slovak, Spanish, Swedish, Thai, Taiwanese, Ukrainian, Urdu, Vietnamese, Wendish, and Yoruba. And because of the immigrant nature of the United States, I know that the domestic mission unit of the Evangelical Lutheran Church is constantly working to develop other language ministries. I also recall a conversation I had with a former China missionary. And this former China missionary said to me, "You know, Bill, we didn't do as well as we would have liked in China, but God is giving us a second chance. The Chinese are coming here." I have a business card from Pastor Paul Nakamura when he was pastor of St. Mark's Lutheran Church in Los Angeles. And St. Mark's Lutheran Church is located practically next door to the University of Southern California, for those of you who know the geography of Los Angeles. And the business card says, "The Reverend Paul Nakamura, pastor of St. Mark's Lutheran Church, a Danish congregation." The Holy Spirit at work, gathering people to be the church together. The Holy Spirit has gathered us to be Peace Lutheran Church in this time and in this place. Through the work and power of the Holy Spirit, we are church together when we face and deal with the COVID-19 pandemic. We are church together when we support each other at this time. We are church together when we pray for each other and the people around us. We are church together when we make face masks for each other and for people who need face masks. We are church together when we reach out to help each other and help our neighbors. We are church together when we minister and work together for change in our nation. We are church together when we shelter in place, practice social and physical distance, and wear face masks, because we love our neighbors and ourselves so that we can protect the vulnerable around us and save lives. We are church together when we help each other and our neighbors to keep on keeping on, knowing that through Jesus Christ we have hope and we are in God's good hands, and that together we will come through this pandemic. Through the work and power of the Holy Spirit, we become Christ for each other and for our neighbors, and therefore that is our witness. We need to constantly remember that the Holy Spirit gathers us and has given us the power to be church together in this time and place, even in the midst of this pandemic. So therefore, our challenge is to remember that we have this power, that we have this Holy Spirit, and to allow this power to come from us, to release this power and see what God can do with every one of us and with us together. And this Holy Spirit continues to be active among us today. Where do you notice the Holy Spirit's movement and work around you? In what ways do you notice the Holy Spirit's movement at work at Peace Lutheran Church? The Holy Spirit works through us and with us to share Jesus Christ with our neighbors and opens the hearts and minds of our neighbors so that they can see Jesus. As you minister and reach out to the neighbors and the people around you, I urge you to notice the movement of the Holy Spirit and to embrace and release the power of the Holy Spirit, which is already in you and among you. The Holy Spirit moves us closer to God and stirs us toward action and ministry. Go where the Holy Spirit blows you. Like that first day of Pentecost, the Holy Spirit will do all it can to cut through, go around, and overcome the barriers that separate us so that all people will come to know Jesus. Not even speaking another language can prevent the Holy Spirit from making Christ known. Through the work of the Holy Spirit, nothing can separate us and the world from God's love. Like the wind, the Holy Spirit blows Peace Lutheran Church into God's future. And where the Holy Spirit blows, we go and be amazed at what the Holy Spirit is able to do with us. Amen.
God, you have moved upon the waters.
Called us.
Together, let us confess the faith that we share by using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Uplifted by the promised hope of healing and resurrection, we join the people of God in all times and places in praying for the church, the world, and all who are in need. We call on your spirit of unity, giving thanks for our different vocations. Activate and utilize the diverse gifts present in your church, that they may reveal your love for all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We call on your spirit of life, present in air, wind, humidity, storms, and oxygen in our atmosphere, breathing energy into all things. Heal with your breath the whole creation, especially those who struggle to breathe due to the coronavirus, air pollution, or lung disease. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We call on your spirit of righteousness. Wherever we as people are divided, unite us. Wherever we are prideful, humble us. Give each one of us a heart for justice and empathy. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Give us wisdom to make plans to safely reopen our church. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We call on your spirit of healing. Bless nurses, doctors, chaplains, counselors, and hospice workers as they care for those in need. We pray for all who long for comfort, especially those in senior care facilities. And for David, Bob, Forrester, Linda, Rod, Marvin, and Margaret. We also pray for the safety of all military personnel, especially Jeff, serving in Iraq. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We call on your spirit of hope. As you have led your saints in all times and places, stir in us the desire to follow your example, leading us from death to new life in you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. With bold confidence in your love, Almighty God, we place all for whom we pray into your eternal care, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Now let us pray together the prayer our Lord has taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Receive this blessing. May the one who brought forth Jesus from the dead raise you to new life, fill you with hope, and turn your mourning into dancing. Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever. Amen.
Risen just as he said. Go in peace, share the good news. Alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia.
Thank you.